In this video, we will study about the cubital tunnel syndrome. So, as the name indicates, so it is a syndrome occurring in the cubital fossa region, and the nerve involved in this syndrome is the ulnar nerve. So we should know the normal anatomy first. So ulnar nerve, as we know, it lies in the anterior compartment in the arm, in the upper arm, and at about 8 cm above the medial epicondyle, there is a arcade of Struthers. So arcade of Struthers is a opening in the medial intermuscular septum through which the nerve enters from the anterior to the posterior aspect. So ulnar nerve enters from the anterior aspect to the posterior aspect through the arcade of Struthers, which is opening in the medial intermuscular septum. So through this, it enters the posterior compartment of the lower arm to the medial epicondyle inferior aspect to continue into the forearm. Now the various areas where the compression of the ulnar nerve can occur in the elbow. So firstly, we have the itself the arcade of Struthers. So first compression can occur at the arcade of Struthers itself, which is opening in the medial intermuscular septum. Then there is a osmone fascia. So osmone fascia is one of the boundary of the cubital tunnel. So now discussing about the cubital tunnel. So it has various boundaries. So this osmone fascia, along with the FCU muscle, which take origin from the medial epicondyle, along with the FCU fascia, it forms the roof of the tunnel. So osmone fascia is a fascia, or it is a ligament which extends from the medial epicondyle to the olecranon process. So this forms the roof of the cubital tunnel. Now the base of the floor of the cubital tunnel is formed by the joint capsule, elbow joint capsule, along with the MCL ligament. So roof is formed by the osmone fascia along with the FCU muscle fascia, and the base is formed by the MCL medial collateral ligament and the joint capsule, and the walls are formed by the medial epicondyle and the olecranon. So this is about the boundaries of the cubital tunnel. So first is the roof. So as we have discussed, it is formed by the FCU fascia and the osmone ligament. Floor is formed by the base is formed by the MCL and the joint capsule, and the walls are formed by the medial epicondyle and the olecranon. Now the where all the compression can occur. So first is the arcade of Struthers. Second is at the level of the cubital tunnel, that is between the osmone fascia. Superiorly and inferiorly there will be MCL and the joint capsule. And the third is at the level of the two heads of the FCU, from where it will enter into the forearm, anterior aspect of the forearm. So the ulnar nerve curves around the base of the medial epicondyle to enter between the two heads of the FCU. So this is another site of the compression. So we have the three important sites. First is the between the two heads of the FCU. Second is the arcade of Struthers. And third is the osmone ligament and the MCL, which is the cubital tunnel itself. So a small point is that there is another existence of Struthers ligament. So Struthers ligament is involved in the medial nerve entrapment syndrome, and arcade of Struthers is involved in the ulnar nerve entrapment syndrome. So various other causes of entrapment, we have the fractures, non-union or medial epicondyle non-union, any external osteophytes or ectotopic ossification causing entrapment of the nerve, any deformity which is more common in the valgus deformity, but cubitus varus deformity can also lead to the cubital tunnel syndrome, medial epicondylitis, any infection of the medial epicondyle, any burns or contractures which can lead to the entrapment of the ulnar nerve. Coming upon to the examination findings, so firstly the patient will complain of the paresthesia in the ulnar nerve distribution area, which is the little finger and the ulnar half of the ring finger on the palmar and the dorsal aspect. And mostly patient will complain of the night symptoms because the patient tend to sleep in keeping the arm in flexion. So the symptoms, they are more likely to occur in elbow flexion. So they are more prone to occur in night only. Then the muscle atrophy can occur because of the atrophy of the interossei and the lumbricals, which are supplied by the ulnar nerve. Then ring finger and small finger clawing can occur. because the lumbricals, which cause the extension at the MCP joint, flexion at the MCP joint and the extension at the IP joint. So when they are lost lumbricals, so this leads to the cloying, which is the flexion at the IP joint and extension at the MCP joint because of the loss of the lumbrical action. So fourth and these ulnar-sided lumbricals, they are supplied by the ulnar nerve. Then there will be weakened grasp and the pinch. So why the grasp and pinch will be weakened? Because the FDP, which insert over the distal phalanx, causing flexion of the distal phalanx, it will be gone because of the involvement of ulnar nerve, leading to the weakening of the grasp. Weakening of the grasp and the pinch is also lost. Now why the pinch is lost? Because of the adductor pollicis. So there is a muscle of the hand on the thinner aspect which is supplied by the ulnar nerve. This is the adductor pollicis, which causes the adduction of the thumb. So as the adduction is lost, so pinch is weakened up. Then coming upon to the another sign, which is known as the Froment sign. So Froment sign, so normally if we ask the patient to hold the book, he will hold using the adductor pollicis. Now in ulnar nerve involvement, adductor pollicis is gone. So patient won't be able to adduct the thumbs, but patient will hold the book by flexing the IP joint. So flexion of the IP joint is caused by the FPL, which is itself supplied by the median nerve. So patient will hold the book like this using the FPL, leading to the flexion at the IP joint, and won't be able to hold the book like this using the adductor pollicis. Then there is another sign known as Wartenberg sign. So Wartenberg sign is that patient, the little finger, they tend to be kept in the abduction position. Now why it is in abduction position? Because the adductors, which is adduction of the finger, is done by the palmar introsci. So as the palmar introsci are involved because of the ulnar nerve involvement, so there is unopposed action of the extensor digiti quinti muscle, which is supplied by the radial nerve. So due to this, the little finger will be kept in the abduction only, known as the Wartenberg sign. So there is a syndrome by the same name known as Wartenberg syndrome. So Wartenberg syndrome is the compression of the superficial radial nerve, which provides the sensory supply of the first web space region. So superficial radial nerve is involved because of the compression at the level of brachioradialis and ECRL. So leading to the Wartenberg syndrome, that is a different. So Wartenberg sign is involvement of the ulnar nerve, and Wartenberg syndrome is involvement of the superficial radial nerve. Then we can have a Tinel sign. Now Tinel sign, as we know, that if we tap on the elbow joint at the level of the ulnar nerve over the medial side, so it will lead to tingling sensation or current like sensation spreading over the entire ulnar nerve distribution. Another test we have is the last test, elbow flexion test. If we ask the patient to keep the elbow in flexion for about 1 to 2 minutes, so this lead to the reproduction of the various signs of the ulnar nerve entrapment, which is the paresthesia. So in treatment part, firstly we will go for the activity modification and splinting in the extension. So flexion was leading to the entrapment of ulnar nerve, so we will keep the upper limb in the 45 degree of extension more in the night, because the symptoms are more likely to occur in the night. So this is this extension brace along with the activity modification and the anti-inflammatory drugs are the first line of the treatment. But even if it fails, so we can go for the decompression of the entrapment causes. So what all causes was leading to the entrapment, we can go for this decompression using the medial approach. So initially we can, if the symptoms are few, we can go for the decompression without the ulnar nerve transposition. But if the ulnar nerve transposition is required, it is required in those cases where firstly decompression has been done without the ulnar nerve transposition, or the patient is having a high demanding patient like that of athlete, where a second surgery cannot be afforded. So in those cases, we can go for the ulnar nerve transposition, anterior transposition. Normally, ulnar nerve is lying posteriorly to the medial epicondyle. So we can go for the anterior transposition of the ulnar nerve. So we transpose the ulnar nerve to subcutaneous, submuscular or intramuscular plane. So that was about the carpal tunnel syndrome. So briefly revising the causes of entrapment, we have the arcade of Struther, we have the osmond ligament, which is the cubital tunnel itself, and we have the two heads of the FCU. Thank you for watching the video.